Hi everyone, welcome to a new tutorial. Thanks for joining me today. Today I have a real-time tutorial for you. It's part of the Patreon tutorial from June. So you can find this full 13-hour tutorial over on there for the $7 tier. And in this video, I'm going to show you part of the fur. So you can find the materials below and let's get started. All right, let's move on with this little area coming forward a little bit using walnut brown. Look at the fur direction. I'm doing this quite quickly because I don't need a lot of detail here on the neck. I am going in the right direction, always. Right, making sure there is a nice base layer there. And next to that shape, we have some shadow, some black I'm going to put in. Alright, so that's the very basic layer. So to tone it down, I want to add some dark sepia to it, 175, to make the fur here a bit more grayish looking. So I'm just glazing that on top. Alright, and this part of the fur is a little bit lighter again. So I don't need any dark sepia on there yet. Alright, I want to mix some burnt umber with it as well, 280.
for the variation. It gives the fur a bit more of a yellow glow as well. Really make sure that this part below the lip is very dark so that the muzzle pops forward. Adding some more black there. Black, I can also add the darkest shadows in between the hairs. So I'm drawing lines in the direction of the fur and I'm leaving open areas, spaces between those lines. And there I'm going to draw the lighter hairs. Fur curves towards the right. Alright, I'm going to draw some lighter hairs now, which I'm going to do with a warm gray. Number 4, 275. No, number 6 this is. It's number 6. Maybe it's too dark, let's see. Yeah, it's a bit too dark. I think I do need number 4. There it is, 273. I'm going to pull out some lighter hairs now. Make it overlap the black. So this will also get rid of the fur the paper texture. Now, to add some color, I'm going to glaze some Caput Mortem on top. A little bit of that, not too much. Maybe also a bit of yellow. I need... Let's do Nougat 178. And then back to walnut brown. Now I'm really going to divide all those hairs. Thank you. and then back to black again. Final layer of darkening up. Right, some final highlighting with the warm gray 4. All right, let's just leave it like this and move on. So here we have this edge that I'm going to fill in with walnut brown. Then we have a lighter edge right here, so I'm leaving that open. And then, the rest of the fur. Let's do that with another brown. Let's switch to Van Dyke. Going for a lighter base layer, so I can add some lighter colors on top as well. And I'm really following the direction of the fur, so it's going like around, then downwards. just mapping out the fur a little bit, the darkest areas, the lightest areas. Alright, and this lighter edge I'm going to color in with nougat. Alright, let's add some more color. I'm going to glaze some Caput Mortem on this fur. Alright, I'm going to add some more darkness in the fur with walnut brown. So I'm really looking at the clumps of fur now. I won't be drawing the hairs individually, that's not necessary. But it will take some time to build this all up and make sure that there's no paper texture showing through anymore. Alright, I think I need some blue on the fur. Need to glaze some blue on there. Let's do sky blue. 146. Let's glaze that on there. To get a nice blue glow. Which I'm also going to do on this part, actually. Just adding some blue hairs. Blending that fur with the background a little bit. Alright, I do need some more color in there. Let's glaze a little bit of pink or cinnamon. This is 189. Let's get rid of that paper texture. Some bistre. So now we're losing the contrast in the fur. That doesn't matter. I'm going to hype that back up again. Alright, let's go in with dark sepia. There it is. Some more contrast, some more darkness in between the hairs. Alright, I'm going to do some final highlighting with sky blue, and then I'm going to move on to this part. Taking some sky blue again, making sure it's nice and sharp. And creating some individual hairs overlapping the darker shadows. I like this blue in the fur. It's a bit different from usual, but it's nice. Bit of black.
Alright, so that sums up this tutorial for today. I hope you enjoyed it. It's just a little part of this project, but it shows the process of the fur quite well. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below, and any suggestions for new subjects are always welcome. And then I want to thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next week on Thursday, 7 PM CEST. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye guys!